Why aren't people rational? Why aren't people more rational? I haven't been to another country, so I can only comment on Americans and the way things are in America. But I have to say that Americans, for the most part, don't think rationally because they're not taught to think. Americans are programmed to believe, but we're not programmed to really think. We're believers, but we're not thinkers. See, believers are easier to manipulate. Believers are easier to control because you don't really have to provide any rational thought, any reasoning, any proof to whatever claim you're making. So with believers, you can feed them any garbage you want and they'll believe you because that's what they've been programmed to do. They've been programmed to believe. But see, when people start to think, it's easier for them to put things together. It's easier for them to pick up on patterns. And I think the whole system is designed to get people to believe and not really think. I think George Carlin was right about the education system in this country. There's a reason why it's so awful, because they don't want any critical thinkers. They don't want people who are capable of challenging whatever they've been told. That's why education is sort of skewed the way it is. If you can remember back in high school, when your teacher was talking about World War II, and your teacher was talking about the Nazis and Hitler, did your teacher ever mention the bankers who backed Hitler? Think about that for a second. Did your teachers ever mention the people who backed Hitler? Not really. And you want to know why? Because those same people have been backing other people like Hitler for a very long time. And the same types of structures exist today. The structures, the types of people who supported Hitler back in the 30s still exist. Not the same exact people, but the same families, the same structure, the same system is in place. So whenever you get in school, you have to understand that they're part of the system. They're part of the structure. The system is going to protect itself. So the education system is designed to provide a very skewed perception of history and what's happening in the real world. And when people are taught to believe and not think, it's easier to feed them garbage. For example, whenever somebody misses 9/11, people believe that anybody who questions the government's official story is crazy. They say you're a nut job. They believe that. But see, you have to understand, they're not thinking, they're believing. You know, if I was to question the government's official story about 9/11, a rational person would say, well, show me proof. And I would point to them various documentaries on the subject. I could talk about loose change. I could talk about the truth behind 9/11 by Michael Rupert. I could point to many holes in the government's official stories. I could say, well, you know, they said the buildings collapsed because of airplane fuel. But a scientist actually discovered thermite in the materials, in the wreckage. I could say, well, Building 7 almost imploded, it collapsed, but it wasn't hit by an airplane. It wasn't even within the immediate blast area. And no steel structure has ever imploded because of a standard fire, ever. I could say, the pilots who hijacked airplanes and flew one into the Pentagon had no training in how to land a plane, and yet one of them was able to pull off a maneuver that was practically impossible, according to a lot of experienced pilots. A lot of experienced pilots would have had a problem doing that maneuver. And yet people will say you're crazy because they believe that. A rational thinker would look into that. A rational thinker would look for the truth. But that's not what people are trained. People are trained to believe, not to think. Now, if I wrote a screenplay and I submitted it to you guys on September 10th, 2001, and in the screenplay, the World Trade Center was attacked, and I explained that Building 7 collapsed because of a fire, a lot of you guys would quickly point out that the fire produced wouldn't be sufficient enough to cause an implosion, especially given the fact that no building has ever gone down because of fire before. But since that building wasn't hit by an actual plane, it's a huge hole in my story. You guys will also point out that how can somebody fly an airplane into the Pentagon, the center, the headquarters of the world's most powerful military, without one camera catching the incident on tape? The most secure place on the planet, and there wasn't one camera that could catch the plane actually hitting the building. A lot of you guys will say, hey, Reginald, your screenplay is lacking. There's holes in your story, Reginald. There's holes in your story, Reginald. You have to change this, you have to change that. But even though people will realize that there will be holes in my story, people aren't capable of realizing that there's holes in the government story. Because they're taught to believe what they're told. They're taught to believe that we're crazy. Just like people are taught to believe that JFK was killed by a lone nut. And that the magic bullet theory exists. You know, it's funny what you can get people to believe. You can get people to believe in magic. But I think part of the reason why people believe this stuff is because they can be comfortable believing it. As long as you believe the nonsense, you don't really have to do anything, because once you start to think about it, you realize how ridiculous the stories are. And that puts you in an awkward situation where you either have to do something about it or sit on your ass and do nothing and not talk about it. For most people, it's more comfortable to do nothing. So that's why a lot of people believe in it. Now, I'm not saying that everything's a conspiracy, but I would like to address some of the concerns that some people have. Some people say that, well, you know, the government would never do this and the government would never do that. Well, these people are believers, not thinkers. Because anybody who's ever picked up a history book would know that the government sponsored experiments in which black men were purposely given syphilis. Purposely. Tuskegee, do you remember that? The Tuskegee experiment? Perfect example. But yet people don't want to think about it, they just want to believe. People say, well, a conspiracy, you can't keep a secret. Well, again, these are beliefs. These aren't actual facts. We know that there are black operations. Now, I'm not saying that the government sponsored the attack on September 11th, but I'm saying their official story doesn't add up. And I think there needs to be an investigation. Now, the idea that the government can't keep a secret is ridiculous. If you have a conspiracy, you don't need everybody participating in the conspiracy to know exactly what the motive of the conspiracy is. You can have a conspiracy with 50 people and only have one or two people who know what the hell is really going on. How? How can that be? Here's how. If you read about World War II, and you read about a lot of Nazis, a lot of them, their most common excuse was, well, I was just following orders. Well, I was just following orders. Don't you think people would do that today? Oh, I was just following orders. You don't need to let every single person in the conspiracy know what's going on. You just need to give people orders. It's called compartmentalization. Now, people who have a hard time thinking about this are probably also the same people who had a hard time thinking about weapons of mass destruction. You know, that's one of the things that really woke me up. 9/11, you know, I was watching the television, I was like, you know, I was looking at other people like, okay, am I the only person watching a building implode almost at a free fall speed? I mean, is this not a demolition or what? And yet people, I mean, they didn't even use their eyes. I mean, it's amazing how people just bleed, you know? They just bleed. You know, if the government will lie to you about weapons of mass destruction to start a war, why would you assume that they're telling you the truth about anything else? I mean, how does that make you crazy for responding rationally? I mean, if I lied to you guys about something really huge, wouldn't you question me about other things? I mean, wouldn't a rational person do that? So, if you want to know how I view things, I'm very critical and I'm very suspicious of everything that's given to me. And that's why I expect you guys to not only watch my videos, if you decide to watch my videos, research some of the things I'm talking about. When I post my links in the articles, I mean, in my description box, I expect you guys to look that stuff up, because sometimes I get things wrong. So I need you guys to just verify everything that I'm telling you. You know, you can't assume anything I say is true. You don't assume anything the government says is true. Don't assume anything that the media says is true. Look at it yourself. Like Gerald Celente says, think for yourself. I love that slogan. I just want people to be more critical. A little cynicism is healthy. It really is. Because you don't want to be a sucker.